I have the filament spool on top of the under 3, and that keeps this area open, and it's a lot easier to get the filament loaded into the extruder. And I use this little turnaround pulley that guides that filament in there perfectly, and it keeps it away from the Z-axis lead screw. Given time, eventually this will quit printing and filament will stop going out the nozzle, and the extruder head will start going click, 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 where it's trying to feed the filament, but it can't, and so this is bouncing back and forth on this spring-loaded mechanism. You can use one of those needles to feed it in through the nozzle and try to clear it that way, but in my experience, that only works about 1 in 20 times. There's usually a piece of junk or something, a large particle that's in the filament that gets in there and plugs that nozzle. And the only way to clear it is to take the nozzle out and clean out the hot end. Just a couple of ideas on how to get the filament loaded through the extruder and entering the Bowden tube a little easier, and then how to effectively clear a plugged nozzle. When I pulled the orange filament out, it came out here and it had a pointed end, a little strand coming off of there. I just nipped that off. Then this will go through the extruder and this will enter the Bowden tube very easily. I have 3 printers, and each one of them, the filament has a problem getting past this push to connect fitting and get started into the Bowden tube. So that pointed end on the filament helps get things started. That orange filament going right through here, if I squeeze this, you can probably see that filament coming around through the Bowden tube. So that pointed end makes that real easy to get that started. It's always a good idea to wear safety glasses when you're messing with this. This filament is very springy. It can very easily come back and stab you in the eye. If you've cut the end of the filament off, one way of getting a point on there again, and cut that off at one direction, cut it off in the other direction, and you end up with a little point on there. What I have found is if I take a cigarette lighter, just flame that end, that makes that point smooth, and then it will load into the extruder a lot easier. When you gently round that point with the cigarette lighter, that loads through there pretty easy. The next challenge is to remove the nozzle and to clean it. Oftentimes when the nozzle comes out, there's a bunch of filament that remains in here. If the nozzle plugs, then you're going to have a bunch of junk in here, and you want to pull that out of there to clear the nozzle. You can use a brand new nozzle, but if you can save one of these, it's probably still perfectly good. Why waste a nozzle that will still work for you? Problem is, when you take this out, it's hot and it's hard to hold on to. I bought a 6mm nut driver. This is a Craftsman tool. Now, word of warning on this, there were 6 of these on the rack and only 2 of them would fit this nozzle. All the others were too tight and you couldn't get the nozzle in. Remember, Craftsman is now owned by Stanley Black & Decker. And in my opinion, you always need to be aware of a possible lack of quality control. If I take this nozzle, it drops down into that socket too far. I don't want it to go that far. So I machined this little piece of aluminum, and there's a hole down inside there. That little stem goes down inside, blocks the bottom of this socket, so that nozzle sticks out like that. With the hot end up to temperature, when I reach up here and I unscrew this wearing a pair of gloves, I can immediately put a finger across that, and you use a long needle nose pliers, a good one, and you reach in there while this is hot and get hold of that filament, pull it out of there. Then you will have a perfectly clean nozzle. I'm going to put a little bit of epoxy down in that hole. That hole comes down to about here. So just put a little bit of epoxy in there and then put this little aluminum piece. You can make something very similar to this with a piece of bamboo. Whatever you put in there has to be temperature resistant or temperature proof. You now have a dedicated wrench for your nozzles. With the nozzle set at 210 degrees, I can now reach up with my wrench, unscrew the nozzle, reach in with my pair of pliers, grab that filament, and pull it out of there. I almost waited too long to pull that out of there, but that, you can even see this little tit on the end of this. That's what came out of the opening in the nozzle itself. So now that nozzle is perfectly clean. And then take a Q-tip, stick it up in there, and I spin it. That will bring out any gunk that's left up inside there. Also cleans the threads for the nozzle. Push some filament back down through there. It will, and cut it off and pull it back out. That'll push any fibers or anything that came off of the cotton swab. It'll push that out of there. When the nozzle is cool, you can reach up in here with your fingers. Start that nozzle back in there before it gets too hot to handle. Give it a second to come up to temperature. Tighten it. You always want to tighten it when it's at operating temperature. And then you need to re-level your bed. And that's it.